95.
Apps all around.
What's worth a click and download?
What's worth a click and download? Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking all about the Facebook today.
you know, honey, in a couple of years, maybe even months down the line, we may not be hosting the show in the studio anymore.
We're in Facebook?
With Facebook, they have plans to just kind of have me talk to a hologram or have you talk to a hologram of me.
Yeah, I mean, it wouldn't be as fun, to be honest. I mean, but, you know, because, you know, Facebook is launching a VR remote work app, and it's calling it a step to the metaverse. Now, We do know the world's largest social network, which is Facebook, has invested heavily in virtual and augmented reality. And Facebook just last Thursday did launch a test of a new virtual reality remote work app where users of the company can use the Oculus Quest 2 headsets and hold meetings as avatar versions of themselves.
Yes, indeed. And we've always known that Facebook has kind of a deep love for virtual reality. They're actually one of the first companies to start experimenting with different headsets to try and make that kind of a very easy reality for us to implement in our own day-to-day life. The beta test that Facebook actually did to test this new technology happened in their very own workrooms. So they had an application that they were setting up with many companies that they were working with remotely that were actually shut down due to the COVID-19 pandemic. And this new VR application helped them basically interact with virtual reality avatars of them. Now, Facebook does see that this is going to be the latest step in working remotely. They feel like no one has done this step before them, and Mark Zuckerberg feels like he's the first on the pedestal, if you could say.
Yes, and now Facebook's vice president of its Reality Labs group said the new workroom app does give a good sense of how the company does envision the elements of the metaverse. And, you know, he said that this is the kind of one of those foundational steps in that direction. Now, you're probably wondering, Hani, what is a metaverse? Well, the term metaverse was coined in 1992 in a novel called Snow Crash, and it's actually used to describe immersive shared spaces accessed across different platforms where the physical and digital coverage. And Zuckerberg has actually described it as an embodied internet. You know how in Avengers, I'll make it kind of a little bit more basic. In Avengers, we have the multiverse, right? Yep. You had different, you know, superheroes all combining into one for Infinity War and Endgame. It's kind of the same thing. We're gathering different platforms and connecting them all into one so we can all be there at the same time, hologram or even as an avatar in our work meetings. Now, in July, Facebook did say it was creating a project team to work on that metaverse, which would be part of its AR and VR group, which is called Facebook Reality Labs. And Omnia, I feel like it's just so crazy that Facebook started off in Harvard dorms, you know,
for
college students to get to know each other, university students to get to know each other. And now 10 years, 12 years later, they are the biggest social media platform on the planet. And they're doing a lot, not only for the social media space, but for technology in general.
Absolutely. And if you're wondering how exactly would this metaverse actually work? So Facebook describes it as basically users would have to download this application, part of the workroom setup that they have installed. And then every employee, let's say, they would have and design an avatar version of themselves. These avatars would meet in a virtual conference room and they would collab on different documents that are shared across all of them. So they're still all interacting with their own physical desk, with their own computer keyboard, but it's all happening in that virtual classroom or workroom, as you may call it. The application, they're planning to have it offered for free for anyone who owns the Quest 2 headset, which would cost about $300. Now, it's an interesting way to also market their headset because they've had them on the market for quite some time, but not many people have actually purchased them. And this workroom would allow up to 16 people at a time to work together in virtual reality and up to 50 if we're talking about a video conference. So if you're not using both the augmented reality and the VR, just let's say the VR, you can have 50 people in one room, which I think would actually be a great way to incorporate and let's say big companies where you kind of don't want to have everyone come and work in person during the COVID-19 pandemic or even after the pandemic. I feel like working remotely is going to stay even after it's all over.
Yeah, I mean, we still see a lot of companies still, you know, implementing their own working from home or remote work. Now, obviously, privacy is a big concern when we're talking about Facebook in general, because Facebook, you know, is kind of shady when it does come to that.
Yes.
Now, Facebook, the company, did say it would not use people's work conversations with and materials in workrooms to target ads on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it also did mention that users must follow its VR community standards and that rule-breaking behavior can be reported to Oculus. Now, talking about the headset, Facebook actually did recently halt sales for Oculus Quest 2 headsets and recalled the foam face liners. That was because reports of skin irritation in cooperation with the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission. So these headsets, you know, they were recalled because it was causing skin irritation, mm-hmm. right? And I mean, that is a very big no-no.
Yep.
You don't want to, you know, you don't want to having your skin problems because you don't want to go to work or you want to be part of the future. I would, if it was causing me skin problems, I wouldn't do it, right?
They recalled it though.
They recalled it, yes, and it did affect around 4 million units in the United States. And again, I do believe that they will master this and recall them and, you know, fix what needs to be done. So maybe in the near future, we might see meetings being held via Oculus. Who knows? Let us know your guys' thoughts, 4215, do our thoughts or on our Instagram at Pulse95 Radio. But ladies and gentlemen, we're taking a short break. And when we come back,
we're talking all about micro robots that can deliver medications straight to your nervous system without you even having to do a thing.
If you liked this episode of Future Talk, drop a like and subscribe.
Pulse95.
Be sure to follow us on Instagram for all our daily updates and top stories.